Thank you. Thank you. Hier ist Übermensch Radio. Diese Radio ist der einzige Radio, das die Ende der Welt überlebt hat. Aber wir haben noch keine Ahnung, was wir mit diesem...
This is Neon Sexy Synth Radio. Sorry guys, it is me, Shane, who just cannot feel pain. Because I am happy, my friends. I am happy because I look good, I have a nice ass, and I have a beauty that lasts forever, you know. A lot of nice cool songs. Just let me talk to you guys about feeling sexy.
We'll be right back. slows the thunder sound. From spring where there are few from the ground. From a cavern of many fall down the ground. And all that never be foolishly said, that my world is gloomy and narrow my bed. For man never slept in a different bed, and to sleep he was slumber in just such a bed. I tend to my spirit here plainly proposes, forgetting or never regretting its roses, its old agitations of mirrors and roses. For now I so quietly lie with fancies, of only a wonder of body of pansies, of those women are, the mingled fit pansies, of you and the beautiful point of pansies. And so it lies happy.
This is Bone Chill Radio on 100.5. This is a real nice coffee. We here at Bone Chill Radio use the magnificent coffee brand, the Sea Keef Coffee. It is the most tasty coffee ever. Especially tasty if you are reading a nice book, you know, reading poems, making love to your rubber wife or your wooden wife if you are old-fashioned like me. Talking about old-fashioned, we have lots and lots of old poems we can read for you because these have no copyright protection on them. So if you are home with your wife, be it rubber, wood, or a real one if you are the luckiest man on earth, or if you are driving in a post-apocalyptic desert in your Choda, your Tarbans or Faltenberger, just sit back, relax, grab a cup of feces, Sea Keef Coffee, and join us. A narrow fellow in the grass occasionally rides. You may have met him, did you not? His notice sudden is. The grass divides as with a calm, a spotted shaft is seen, and then it closes at your feet and opens further on. He likes a boggy acre, a floor to cool. And was gone.
dirty old car and you want to make it look better, jizz on it. Try our new product, the Jizz on It Car Polish. You just grab it with your hands, pull on it a few times, and boom, you already got some jizz on it. With our new powerful product, cleaning and making your car shiny is as easy as a breeze. It protects from rain, acid rain, volcanic ashes, atomic ashes. Hell, it even protects against terrorism. Jizz on it. If there is something wrong with it, just jizz on it.
Thank you.
get it? But in the heat of the moment, it is hard to imagine ourselves in the place of the other guy. But hell, we should do that. Not saying I can do that, actually, because I can't. I just punched the guy in the face. The pitiless pain. Has abated the terrible torture of thirst for the naphthalene. We'll be right back. Hello, sir. How are you doing?
Hey, I'm Shane from Steel Pants. You know, I had it with you guys always mocking us. Please cut it out, okay?
I'm Shane, too. Why do you pick the same name as me? I'm not original.
Shut up, you little pansy, or I'll find you and beat you to the bones.
This is why our radio is much more friendly than yours. You rockers are so aggressive.
Whatever, by now, you little moron.
Yes, it's radio. We don't care about Steel Pants. FM 98.4.
This is Neon Synth Radio, FM 98.4.
You know, last night I was out shopping. It was easy because the shop is abandoned. And I bought myself some new pants. No, not steel ones, but tight, hot ones. They are hot, my man. They make my butt look like shiny, healthy, round apples, you know. Hey, you steel pants guy, bite me. Jennifer, will you stand by the reason, please?
So sad that more than 90% of the population died, including women.
I guess so. Do you miss your wife?
Say, what? How do you know that?
The Rubber Woman 2000 comes in all shapes and sizes. You only got half the price? No problem, we can sell you half the wife.
What?
That's right, you heard it. If you only have the money for half a rubber wife, we give you half. We give you one without legs. Order now. With the new rubber technology, your rubber wife feels just like your real one did. No talking, no arguing, and her head never hurts. Give it a try. Say your wooden wife a big goodbye.
Whoa, it really feels like my old wife did.
Of course it does. Rubber Wife 2000, coming in stores near you. Do you have any stores near you? No? Well, you can order one through the phone also. Rubber Wife 2000. Watch out for the cacti.
is Neon Synth Radio.
The weather out there is almost as hot as me, my friends. Well, not really. I am much, much hotter than that. Last week, we had a caller that said I sound like the guy from that shitty Steel Pants radio, but seriously, how can you say something like that? I mean, that dude is a douchebag and he has serious personality disorders, or bipolar, or bisexual stuff. Mostly the weather will be sunny, just like my life and yours. Let's make it even better with one of my favorite songs. Jennifer, hit it!
Neon Synth Radio, FM 98.4.
If you have a rusty old car and you need some oil, use the extra virgin car oil, available anywhere in the desert. It is smooth, like your sexy girl's voice. It is the best lube for your car. Extra virgin car oil. Buy it or find it somewhere. Good for two-stroke engines also. Thank you.
this is Halloween now. As you may all know, sadly, since the apocalypse, we don't really know what year it is, since the time moves strange and no one remembers. But these pumpkins now give us a clue, at least about what season it is now. Well, you know, the old season. What was its name again? Autumn. Anyways, watch out all of you out there on the roads. I already started collecting them. I have exactly 69 pumpkins here in the studio. And you? Get out there and get them!
This announcement was sponsored by Post Apocalyptic Food Services. We bring food for you. We'll be right back.
shine on like a disco ball, my friends. This is Shane, who is not profane. I was thinking about going shopping today when I realized all of my favorite shops burned down a while ago. I was hungry and I thought to myself, wow, I need a Vegemite sandwich. Then I realized I'm not in Australia. Oh well, back to eating some bugs. Bye, my friends. Lots of hugs.
Radio.
Have a wonderful day, my friends. I forgot to tell you before that only girls and boys with sexy bodies can listen to this radio station. If you're an ugly person without style, please turn off the radio now, okay?
Radio. Here is der Übermensch Radio. Ich bin Hans Zimmermann aus Deutschland, der beste Land aller Zeiten.
Schmetterling. Himmel, Donnerwetter!
Heute ist es sehr heiß, heißer als in einem Ofen, das in Deutschland gebaut worden ist. Da ist in meiner Wiener Schnitzel. Ich muss ganz dringend Pipi machen, sonst kann ich nicht Radio machen. Ich möchte nicht in der Studio Pipi machen. Och Gott im Himmel, warum ist es so heiß heute? Was ist denn nun schon wieder los heute? Ha? Hört ihr mich, Leute? Was ist nun heute los?
Übermensch Radio, der beste Radio aller Zeiten.
Himmel, Donnerwetter, Schmusenschwein. Ich muss dringend ein Zweitakter-Fahrzeug benutzen. Jemand bitte gebt mir ein Zweitakter jetzt. Ich muss dringend auf dem Toilette, aber ich fahre nur mit einer Zweitakter-Fahrzeug in dem Toilette hinein.
Heilige Scheiße, Toilettenbusenhalter. Nur zum Nachrichten. Deutschland ist immer noch der beste Land aller Zeiten. Es hat Sand, aber auch wenige Bäume.
Ja, ihr habt es gut gehört, die Penner. Deutschland hat noch einen kleinen Wald.
Werbung. Rufen Sie jetzt an, wenn Sie eine Gummipuppe kaufen wollen. Wir haben noch eine übrig und sie hat auch ihre Füße. Ich sage euch, Deutschland hat alles, was ihr möchtet.
Konrad, du Mistflieger, du feige Sau, wo bist du?
Übermensch Radio, FM 97.5.
der hardest radio aller Zeiten. So, meine liebe Leute, wir haben einen wunderschönen Wetter heute. Ich bin so froh, dass ich hier arbeiten kann. Ich bin Hans Zimmermann und ich liebe euch alle. Dieser Werkplatz ist der beste. Ich habe kein Geld, aber die Post bezahlt mich mit Hundefutter. Hundefutter ist so lecker. Ich habe eine gute Story für euch. Wenn ich jung war, lange bevor der Ende der Welt, wir hatten mit meiner Freundin eine riesengroße Party. Wir waren so besoffen. Wir kotzten wie die Schweinehunde, tranken Bier, hatten so viel Spaß. Heute aber kannst du größtenteils nur diesen ungarischen Bier trinken, Lonyal oder...
You know what I hate? People telling me what to do, and they love doing that. They want to tell you how to live your life, they want to tell you what you should eat, where you should buy your stuff, what kind of car you should drive, and what kind of a woman you should marry. They want to tell you what kind of shoes you should be wearing, what kind of beer you should be drinking. They want to tell you how to take a crap, how to sleep, how to breathe. They want everyone to do the same thing they do. And when someone comes along and says, hey, I do this way, and I think you are doing it the bad way, and you are wrong. And then they get angry. But why? I mean, they are doing the same thing to other people. Why don't they notice this? But hey, I have some good news. Since we are living after the end of the world now, well, these people are all dead. Angry Greg likes people dead. This is Angry Greg's Rage Radio on 96.6. Okay, now I'm really, really frustrated. Like, what's up with all the cacti in this world? Why are there so many of them? I just want to, you know, I try to run them over, but as I kill one, there is another one. And there is just, you know, no end to them. Like, if I would have a truck or a bus, I would just mow them down and scream while I'm doing it, you know. But these things, they just keep throwing me around and slowing me down. I just... God, I hate them. You know, last week I found a few guns and even a BB gun. I was just shooting at them. Shooting them, screaming, hey, you bastards, you are going to die by my hand. You little green bastards. Keep staring at me. Shut up, I swear I can hear them talk. I just hate them. Hypocrites. My God, where do I even start with these bastards? And what always bugs my mind, do hypocrites know they are hypocrites? Did ever just one of them admit it to being one? Well, that goes for all the other things too, you know, stuff like when you say, he's an idiot, and when you say, hey, George is a dumb guy. Does George know he is a dumb guy? Did ever just one person on earth acknowledge or admit that he's one of the above mentioned? I think not. But this is a topic for another time. Let's talk about hypocrites. Do any of you uneducated survivors know what that even means? Chances are, if you don't know what a hypocrite is, you are one. Oh, and by the way, by educated, I mean you can educate yourself at home too. Read some freaking books, look around, sit down, think, use your brain. That's what it's for, my man, or my woman. While I don't have any women, I don't like them, and I tell you why. They are also hypocrites. And I'm being honest, it is scientifically proven that more women are hypocrites than men. But that is an evolutionary reason. They have much higher expectations to live up to. And when they cannot live up to these aforementioned expectations, they pretend to live up to them, thus making them hypocrites. They become hypocrites, like weird-ass creatures transforming in the night under the moonlight. But let us not stray away from our main topic. Let me, Angry Greg, educate you a bit. So hypocrisy is basically saying stuff and then not doing that stuff. Like preaching about eating healthy. And then you go home and eat the most unhealthy food you can just hope to find in your fridge. Pretending to be faithful and saying nasty things about people who have sex with a lot of people, then going home and spreading your legs for the post guy or the milkman. Or if you're a guy, telling everyone that you love your wife. And you tell everyone that all the other guys are dumb for thinking with their penises, and then, you know, you go out of town and you're putting your pee-pee into various women in various ways. So actually, you are doing the exact opposite of what you are saying, because you want to be seen in a good light in the eyes of other people. And this is an interesting thing also. Why do most people want to be seen as a good guy with a good life, a good wife? Come on, just admit it. You're an asshole. You're a dirty, junk food eating, whore mongering, not wiping your ass after a crap taking ass bandit. And girls, you are whores. You like sex the same way as we do, even more dirtier, just admit it. We are filthy animals. This is Angry Greg. And you all can lick my leg. Angry Greg's Rage Radio, FM 96.6. If your face is wrong, I know a good fix. And I run away with the chicks. Okay, you know what I really, really hate? The school system. The education system. Like, I want to study what I like, what I'm interested in. You know? I know, we all should be able to read and write and, you know, do some basic math and stuff. Math can be important. But other than that, I'm just not impressed with the way schools work. I mean, if I'm interested in history, I want to focus on that and not freaking chemistry class. I mean, it always felt like they were wasting my time and the English grade things. Why do you need a car for? I mean, now in the apocalypse, you have to drive to survive, to find food and water and whatnot.